Guys, Linda here. Well, I think I found my container for my swap that I'm in. I made trucks. I made jars. I made bicycles, but I think I'm going to end up with envelopes. I was watching Steffi at Coffee, Paper, Scissors, and she was making little envelopes out of book page, and I thought that was really cute. So I think I'm gonna do something like this and put a couple pieces of lace, maybe a bow and a sentiment, and then that will go maybe with some background paper and that I think is gonna be my container for my flowers. I really like that. This is very old book page and it is very, very brittle. So, I shouldn't have glued that. When I, fold it, I have to be very careful that I don't, that it doesn't rip. But the best part about this kind of deal is when you're putting it on a card or it's not going to be moved. It's going to be permanent. It can be glued back together. But I did take two pages each and I sprayed some E6000 on it and then let it dry, then cut it down. So the paper is 5.5 inch square, but then you start the fold at 2 3/8. I think it's, 2 3/8. I meant to put this in here before I put the, before I folded it up. Sophie's right in front of me. She's totally blocking the monitor, so I have no idea what you're seeing. So let me go, let me show you how I do that. So here's a piece of book page. And I line this up with 2 3/8 and punch it. And I don't have to do all these scores, these long scores, because one stands up. But I've been tapping it in some ink, and it just helps me line it up a little better when I turn it like this, because you don't use the 2 3/8 anymore. You use this line or this score line. And with this paper, I don't want to press too hard because, like I said, it's so brittle. So now this is going to be a short side, so I can do that one. I have to punch all the sides, but I don't have to, I really don't have to score this next one because that's the one that's going to stand up. The only trouble is, where do I line it up? So what I'm going to do is put it back in here, line it up, and I'm just going to take and, lightly score it so I can kind of see. I think I can see where that is. But it gets covered up with the doily anyway, so it doesn't really matter. All right, so then you fold it in, and these are the short sides. And then I can decide, do I want this as my top or that as my top? And really doesn't matter to me. The scoreboard, it actually has a little thing back here that you punch to get the rounded edge, but I don't want to keep moving it, so I'm just using my crocodile thing here. I didn't do that one quite right. All right, so then I'm going to ink it, and I got this from, this is that Kitsch Flamingo. I got it from, oh, is this Distress Ink? Yeah, from scrapbook.com. I ordered like a little kit, I guess. And they came in it. It has some alcohol inks too. You know, that's the thing. I sit there and order stuff, and then it's like it comes and it's like, okay, why did I order that? And how do I use it? Well, then I have to go online. Okay, so then this one folds up, and I'm just gonna ink. I'm just inking what shows. Pretty much all of it shows, doesn't it? Like these two parts are the only parts that don't show. But this is really fun. Steffi made these really cute little envelopes to put in journals and little tucks and stuff. Oh, they're really cute. So if you haven't seen her video, be sure to check her out at Coffee Paper Scissors. She is one crafty lady. Okay, hope I'm on the screen. So then I just put the doily in. And then the last step will be to put the flowers in, but I think I need to make some more flowers and cut some paper for background and decide what sentiment I'm gonna make. So, but I just wanted to put the camera on while I was doing this, and there will be, I will finish it when that part gets. So see, now I have to line this up just right so that it fits inside the, you know, so I can still fold it. Yeah, there we go. It's kind of bad though when I put the flowers on. It kind of, and then I'm just putting just a little bit of glue here so I can still get in and around there, and then that'll all get glued down eventually. Like that. But the bad part is, you know, it took so much time to cut all those doilies, and then I'm covering them all up with flowers, but I might rearrange that. We'll see. All right. I will show you when I get to the next step. Now I'm working on the flowers, and I have a bunch made and cut and colored and different ones to use. I've been using these. Oops, don't want to lose that. And these are flowers from My Favorite Things Dynamics, and let's see, they put the names on the plastic part. It's called Stitched Garden. And the doily is from this set. This needs to go in here. And this is from Spellbinders. So that's an older one too. This is new though. Okay, so the flowers. These are punched from the Stampin' Up stamp or punch. And I just went around them with a little bit of Copic marker to make stand out a little bit. And then the stems, they're from another set. They, I think, are from, yeah, they're from this step, which is Bouquet Bunch Framelit dies from Stampin' Up. And that's 143659. That's where the branch came from. I also punched out a bunch, or die cut a bunch of their little flowers too, because I really like to use those. And like I said, I was going to use the bicycle and the jar. So the jar that I started had flowers from that set. But I'm using the branch. I'm using this punch, and then I'm using some of these flowers from the My Favorite Thing. So this is the way they're kind of looking with their flowers, and I'll just show you how I'm doing that too. I wasn't happy with the color I chose for the branches, so I'm taking, they just didn't pop like I wanted it to. So I'm just taking a Copic marker and coloring them a color, you know, another green that I thought made it stand out a little bit. And the coloring's not perfect. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not really saturating the color, and I kind of like that because then it, I don't know, it just has a little bit more depth. It's so funny when I'm watching videos and someone's stumbling for a word. Boy, I have all their words. But when I'm stumbling for a word, they never come until I'm like editing. And then it's like, oh, I'm not gonna stop and put that word in there. Sometimes I add the word, but, oh, brother. Okay. So I feel like this just gives a little bit more texture and depth to it. All right, so then I take the envelope, and the first thing I was doing was sticking in these bigger, now I can't find my glue. Oh, here it is, it's laying down. Taking a nap, I've been working it pretty hard today. I didn't color all the way around it because it's going to get tucked in here. So I'm just putting a pink one and a purple one in there. And I've kind of, each one I kind of thought, oh, now how do I want to arrange it? So I put those in first, and then I put in the stem. And this would have been good too. Put on sticky back paper, but sometimes these really fine, well, that's when it's best to use them. Oh, I know what I have. It's on my desk too. I have one of these Xyron things that I probably should use up. It's so old. I wonder if it would even stick. I get kind of frustrated with those because the sticky is sometimes on top. It doesn't all go off on the release sheet. So, I don't know. Okay, so I have those on there. And I was kind of looking at the ones I had done to see which ones I liked the best. And so I really kind of like this one. I like this flower. Let's see. Here's my container. I just die cut a bunch and then I colored them. I die cut them all in white, and then I colored them with Copic markers. So I kind of liked that arrangement. I think I might do that again. It's a shame that I've covered up the whole doily because it's so pretty. Well, you can still see it pretty good, can't you? All right, so we're going to put these on here. All right, so then what I do is I go through and I'll put the flowers in all of them. You know, first I folded them all and inked and put the doily in. This step now I'm putting all the flowers in. The next step will be the ribbon that I'm going to use. Let's put that one down there. And I like this one to have like this little piece in it. I should have put that on there first. Oh, it's not on there yet, so I can put it on there. I saw, was it on? Oh, I know. It was one of the die cut. I get an email from one of the die cut places, and I can't think of who it is. I get one every day. And she had these beautiful envelopes that are like 3D, and you can, when you put it in the envelope, it's flat, and then when you take it out, you pull it, but it's was full of flowers like this, and I just thought that was so cute, and that's kind of where I got the idea. So I think that one's good. When I go back to put the ribbon around, I might make some changes. I'm kind of like that. So again, I'm just going to put the purple on the outside, or down in the bottom, my left, right there. It's kind of like the fillers. I'm putting the fillers in first when you usually put those in last, don't you? Like the baby's breath and all that. That's okay. That one in there. Get a stem. So these are really fun. I'm so glad I'm using that old book paper. I was trying to make pages out of it for my journals, but it doesn't work so good. Just too brittle. But I can always back it with other paper or something. Take one of these. You can't even see them. There's a really big blue one. And some of these just have the stem. That one needs a little bit more green. So I'll sit and color these while I'm watching television. Lately, I've been watching a lot of Everyone Loves Raymond, and oh my gosh, I just sit there and laugh out loud. It is so funny. I don't know if any of you watched that, but the episode I watched today when I was having my lunch, his dad lost his taste, and the mother, you know, just went ballistic when he asked for salt. And it wasn't because it needed salt, it was because he was taking these pills. And he said the pills were for his foot. But it wasn't his foot. It was like a Viagra kind of pill. And oh my gosh, it was just hysterical, the whole episode. And the boys are reading the ingredients. They're trying to figure out why he doesn't have any taste. He said, the only thing I'm doing different, he pulls these pills out of his pocket. I'm taking them for my foot, he says. And then, you know, your foot. And he's going, yeah, my foot. And oh my gosh, they finally figure it out. And it's just, it's so funny. It's just, I think it's the funniest show. Oh, what a cast. All right, so that's the way they look. You never know. I might go back in and put more down in here, but I'm not sure yet. But this is what I'm doing so far. All right, so when I get to the next step, I'll turn the camera back on. So the last step in the video, I took this. This is a Hero Arts die. I love these flowers too. And it has a couple cute bumblebees. So I made these little bumblebees. Oh, I put them all together. I put some lace on them and I stitched just down here. And then I attached it to some designer paper that I kind of went with the yellow background. Some of them have like a floral print. This one actually has a butterfly there. But so I wanted to put a little bee on it. And I love the story of the bumblebee that Mary Kay Ash used to tell back in the 70s, I sold Mary Kay, and I just loved her philosophy. I loved her product. It was the only thing that didn't make my face break out. My wedding day, I bought Clinique makeup, and I didn't try it, and I put it on my wedding day, and by the end of the day, I had these big quarter-size circles all over my face. But then I went to a Mary Kay party and put the stuff on, and I told the lady I can't buy it because I'm afraid my skin will break out. And so she gave me and then they didn't have samples, you know, she just gave me little bits on something, I can't even remember, and it just felt so good and my skin didn't break out. Well, then she was leaving town or the business or whatever and because she was elderly. And so I decided I was going to sell it. And that was, it was a good thing, but that was like my first year of marriage or second year of marriage. I got pregnant with Jenny, and I'm trying to teach first grade, do these sales, and that was just a little much. But anyway, I love the story that we had to share. And the story was, one, she gave bumblebees out because bumblebees, really shouldn't be able to fly because their bodies are so big and their wings are so small. And the reason she started her business was to give women at the time an opportunity to fly, to earn money. And it was great. I just think she was an amazing lady. And then the other thing, I love the story of the hide tanner that we told at our meetings, that she worked with a hide tanner to come up with her formulas. If they could make a cow skin smooth and supple, then there should be a way to do that with women's skin. And that was a story that you told at your classes. So I just thought she was a pretty amazing lady. The company, I'm sure, has changed many times over since her passing, but I thought the original was pretty spectacular. Anyway, so I'm putting these little bees on, and I just, whenever I see a bumblebee, I think of her because she always wore this diamond bumblebee because it could fly and it shouldn't be able to because its body's so big and its wings are so small. Anyway, so I told you about the lace. Then I put a little paper flower and a little bling on there. And then I have a whole bunch of charms. And I wasn't sure, these charms are bird charms. Little bee. I tried doing on like tissue paper because I thought the wings would look cool, but that didn't work out for me as good. So let's see. And I have like these little peace doves, but I kind of think those are more wedding. And here's one with a little envelope, which is kind of cute. That might make it. I'm not sure how many of those I have. Then the other thing I thought was a butterfly charms. Let's see. I used to have all this stuff in, like those plastic things, storage things that have all the little drawers. But when I downsized, I had to get rid of so much stuff. So now I just have two big containers with plastic bags, and I kind of have them in alphabetical order. So that helps. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I think that's just enough. This one's a little different. Where is it? That one. This one's the same. Not that that's real important. So it's either going to be that or, let's see, what do we have for butterflies? I have, those are bumblebees, kind of. These are really tiny those are dragonflies. It's a little bigger butterfly. But I'm thinking that is going to be it. Yeah, I think these are going to, they are making the cut. So what I'll do is I will attach these to here. And I think that will call it done. I'm trying to decide, do I want to put a sentiment on it or just leave it blank for the person, the idea of the swap is you leave the, you know, you don't write a personal message so that the recipient can, reuse it or send it on to somebody. But I'm not sure what sentiment I want to put on it. I was going to put, be happy, don't worry. That's like, oh, my mantra. I have to do that all the time. When I was young, I had a friend who told me, let's see, what did he say? He said, don't worry about nothing, because nothing's going to be all right. And I'm a big worrier. I don't know if that'll work or not, but we're going to just tuck it in there. Could tie it on with something, but I think it'll work just to put it on there like that. So what do you think? Got all kinds of things going on there. I really feel like I need to put a message or down here or something. But I'll think about that. So that's where I am so far. Here's the finished card. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you're having a great day. Bye.